You've just been so chatty this morning.
More. Yeah. Yes, you have got something to say. Yeah. Preach it, sister. We are here for Sophie's 3-month update already. I can't believe my baby girl is 3 months old already. The time is just flying by. Yeah. We'll see how long she lasts here. I just put Alex down for his nap, and I usually put her down right after I put him down. So we'll see how long she lasts here. I'll probably have to stop and put her down for her nap. But... And she was getting fussy right away, so we're putting her down for a nap now. So that was a nice little segue to talking about Sophie's sleep. So she is doing great with her sleep, with the exception of when we were sick this last week or two. You probably saw my video last week when we were sick, and she was up a little bit more than usual then just because she was feeling sick. I mean, but that's kind of to be expected. And other than that, her sleep has been doing great. Her regular sleep schedule during the night is I put Alex down around 8:30, and then I do her bedtime routine and put her to bed, and she's usually in bed around 9 now. And then she usually sleeps about 8 to 9 hours straight at that point. So I'm usually getting up with her around 5 or 6 in the morning and nursing her, and I usually have to re-swaddle her because she's a little Houdini baby, and man, she gets out of that swaddle. But I re-swaddle her, nurse her, and put her back down and turn on her white noise. And she usually will go to sleep then for another good 3 hours after that. So that's pretty darn good. The only problem is that sometimes after I am up and nursing her at 5 in the morning, I sometimes have a hard time falling back asleep again. And I eventually do, and you know, usually by like 6 or 6:30, maybe 7 sometimes, and then Alex is waking up around 8. So, you know, it's still broken sleep that I'm getting. However, there have been a few nights when she's gone even longer than that. She's for probably about 4 or 5 nights here and there, she's done a 10-hour stretch, and then her record, it was amazing. Night before last, she did 12 hours, guys. She went from 9 p.m. to 9 a.m. And like, I woke up at like 8:30 and I looked over at the clock expecting it to be 5. And I was like, what? It's 8:30? And she was still asleep. I didn't hear a peep out of her. And I was like worried. I'm like, is she okay? And so I went into her room and checked in. She was doing just fine. She was still asleep. So I let her go. I let her keep sleeping. And she slept for another half an hour until 9 o'clock. And when I went in there, she had her little hands out of her swaddle. I'll put a picture in here, but it was so cute. She has become a thumb sucker. Last week she's really discovered how to suck her thumb and like intentionally get her little thumb up there and start sucking it. And so I think that that actually had something to do with helping her get longer through the night, because it was, you know, a self-soothing thing, and she was able to connect her own sleep cycle at that, you know, 5 o'clock, 6 o'clock time and get herself back to sleep. So, but then again, last night it was our usual waking up at 5 o'clock. So it's definitely not consistent by any means yet, but man, I felt so good having like a solid night's sleep. It was amazing because I've been pretty used to just having one waking in the night, but having just a solid night's sleep, it was amazing. So she's doing really well in that department. So while we're talking about sleep, I'll talk a little bit about the schedule that we're getting into now. We've really just kind of naturally been falling into a good rhythm and getting into a pretty good schedule. It's not entirely consistent yet, and I'm not freaking out about that, but it's starting to get a lot more consistent, which is great. So my ultimate goal during the day was to get Alex's nap schedule and Sophie's nap schedule synced up so that I can have a break during the day to either nap myself or to get things done. And we are definitely moving in that direction. We've gotten into a rhythm now where, and this is something that I was worried about before I had her, because I was like, oh, I'm probably going to have two kids napping at different times and I'm not going to get a break at all during the day. And so I really wanted to like work on getting them synced. Anyway, so what I've done is to start just focusing on that one main nap for Sophie in the afternoon at the same time that Alex is napping. And the way I've done that is to just make that the one nap that I swaddle her for. We swaddle her at night and that really helps her sleep a long stretch at night. And so I figure, you know, that's a signal to her that this is the time to sleep. This is, you know, we're going to take a long stretch of sleep here. And it's worked. Usually after I put Alex down for his nap, it's just like the bedtime routine. Then I do her little nap time routine and get her swaddled and I nurse her and rock her a little bit. And put her down in her crib. It's the one nap I put her in her crib for too. And she has been taking like 3-4 hour naps. So she's been sleeping from like 1:30 until like 4:30 or 5:30. It's awesome. And so, when I had Alex, first time mom, I was like, I have to have 3 naps that are like equally spaced and they're all the exact same amount of time. And this time I'm like a lot more lax about it. I'm like, how can we work this so that I can work the baby schedule into our schedule? So it just kind of fell into place that what I'm doing is having her do one giant nap in the middle of the day that's like the 3 or 4 hours. And then in the morning and the evening, I'm having her just do little cat naps. And I don't put her in her crib. I don't swaddle her for those. I just put her in the swing or, you know, we can be out and about and she'll just be sleeping in her car seat or, you know, whatever. Sometimes, you know, if we're just at home, I'll just snuggle her and she'll sleep on me on the couch while I'm reading to Alex or something like that. So definitely keeping like the morning and the evening nap a lot, you know, more lax and not doing the like main signals of like swaddle, rock, nurse in her crib, like, cause that's the signal to her to do a long stretch of sleep. So not doing that in the morning and the evening nap, she takes shorter naps. She will usually go for, you know, maybe like half an hour to maybe an hour. They're much shorter naps. And that's working out beautifully because that allows us to still have a lot of flexibility and it still allows us to go out in the mornings and go out in the afternoon and just have that middle of the daytime be everyone's rest time. So that's been working out beautifully. So yeah, that's going really well. She's still an extremely mellow baby, with a couple exceptions. When she is hungry, she will let us know about it. And a few weeks ago, she was kind of getting into this pattern where she was only pooping like every 3 days. And by that third or fourth day, she was getting uncomfortable and she was letting us know about it. And she'd have these fussy days where she was like fussy all day long and it was not fun for anyone. And at the end of that stretch, she would like poop like 3 or 4 times in one day and then she was happy again. And so it was, you know, we were starting to like get a little anxious because she was getting into this cycle of like every 3 to 4 days. And you know, by that third or fourth day, we were all starting to get anxious because she would get so cranky. But that only lasted for about a week or so. So we're really glad that that little phase is passing because she's much happier now. She's now getting into a routine of pooping every day now. So that's good. Speaking of that, we finally made the transition to doing cloth diapers full-time now, at least when we're at home. I still am doing disposables when we leave the house, if we're going to be out for a long period of time anyway. If we're just running out to the store or whatever, I leave them in their cloth diaper. But I have now switched her to cloth at night. She is now big enough that she can fit into our one-size diaper covers. I'm so excited about it. Stay tuned, because I'll be doing a video about that in the next few weeks, just like our main cloth diaper stash. But that means that we can fit, you know, a pre-fold plus a doubler or a doubler insert in there, which is what is necessary for night without leaks, just because you need that extra absorbency, especially if she's going to be in it for 12 hours like she was the other night. So we finally tested that out and it worked. We had no leaks, so I'm really glad that we're finally full swing cloth diapering now. Anyway, talking about her temperament again, I'm really starting to learn the way she is, and that she's actually very different than Alex in some ways. Even though she's really chill, when she does get agitated and upset, she is not comforted in the same way Alex was. And you know, we had a couple weeks of like figuring that out and having some frustration, because Alex was a binky kid. He still is. We took his binky away during the day a long time ago, but he still has to have it to sleep. And we call him the little Binkinator because he loves his binky. And so I was just fully expecting her to love the binky just as much and for it to be just as effective when she's upset. Give her the binky and it calms her right down. Nope, not the case. She does not like the binky. I mean, she would kind of take it the first few weeks if we kind of held it there and finally got her to latch onto it, but she would only suck on it for a minute and spit it out. And now she won't even take it at all. Like, you know, you put it in her mouth and she gags on it, she spits it out, and it makes her cry even more. So it's like, so much for the binky. We're gonna have to find some other methods. So we definitely had a little bit of frustration trying to figure that out. And finally, I realized what works best for her is white noise. Like, that is her thing. It works way better than the binky. And so I have this little white noise app on my phone, which has been a savior so many times, especially when we're out in public and she starts getting fussy. I just put on the white noise and most of the time it calms her right down. It's just really interesting how, like, you know, what works for one baby really doesn't necessarily work for the next, you know? And so I'm learning, and I think we're definitely figuring things out now too. And same with Alex. Like, when he was fussy, if I nursed him, that would calm him right down. But she's not as much of a barracuda baby as he was. You know, he was like all, you know, like I mentioned in my last update, he was all business about nursing. I mean, he was just like, get it done fast, you know? And she likes to sip. Alex was all about, you know, living to eat, but she's all about eating to live. And so nursing doesn't necessarily comfort her in the same way it did for Alex either. I mean, she nurses when she's hungry and that's it. She doesn't really want to comfort nurse. So sucking to soothe her really isn't her thing, except, like I mentioned, she has started sucking her thumb and it's really cute. So she's, and I think she's right-handed because she always turns to the right and sucks on her right thumb, and she always kind of like has her fingers up in her face and stuff while she's sucking her thumb. It's really cute. So she does have that a little bit, but her need isn't quite as strong for that as it was for Alex. So we're definitely all about the white noise now. And I've also learned to just preventing her getting fussy. It has a lot to do with just, you know, either she's hungry, or the main thing is she's often tired. You know, sometimes when she seems unconsolable, when she finally falls asleep, then she takes a really good nap. I'm like, oh, well, I should have just put her down for her nap a little bit earlier. Then she wouldn't have gotten this fussy in the first place. So I'm learning. I'm slowly learning her as an individual and what her needs are. And I think we're getting into a good rhythm, because we've had a lot less fussy time now. Like, I can anticipate what she's going to need and get it for her before she gets, you know, out of control cranky. So I feel like we're in a good place there. And most of the time, she's, like I said, she's just so chill most of the time anyway. So we have this little mamas and papas. It's not a bumbo seat, but it's just like a bumbo seat. But yeah, so she's big enough now that she can sit in this thing, and she has that neck and like upper back control now, which is awesome. And I love it, because this thing, I can just put it wherever we are and include her in our activities a lot more now, which is great. Because before it was like, couldn't put her on the floor because I didn't want Alex to, like, you know, trample all over her. And it was usually I would either be holding her, which made it difficult to get things done, or I would be putting her in the swing. But now that she can sit, it's awesome. And when she's awake, she loves watching what we're doing. So I just put her in this little seat, and, you know, I put her on the floor when I'm playing with Alex, or I will put it up on the table, like, while we're all eating, and she likes, you know, watching us eat, and we can all interact. She's at the same, you know, face level as we are. I know it's like a no-no to put the thing on the table, but honestly, it's common sense, guys. Like, don't put it next to the edge, right? Like, she's not wiggling in the thing yet, so... And I always keep an eye on her the whole time she's in it. So it's so cute to see her in this thing. But what's really funny about it is we call it the poop chair because half the time we put her in this thing, she poops. Like something about her just bending in that way or whatever it is, it's really funny. So, but she just looks so cute sitting in it and she just looks like this little person now. She just, you know, she's no longer a newborn. She's like a baby now. So I took her for her 2-month checkup with our nurse practitioner around her 2-month mark, and everything was looking great in terms of her development. There were no concerns. The only thing is that she's had this goopy eye. It's on her left eye, and it's been goopy for like a month now, and I haven't been consistent enough about putting breast milk in it, and when I do, it actually helps, but I've just been bad at remembering to do that. So we're actually going to be going in for her 3-month checkup next week, and I may ask just for some drops to help with that because it's been going on for like a month now, but that's the only health concern with her. But she had her first vaccines at the 2-month appointment. In fact, I talked about it in the controversial parenting tag. I'll link that down below. But we definitely believe in vaccinating our children, but we do it in a spread out schedule so that they don't get any more than 2 vaccines in any given month. So she had, I think it was the Tdap, which is like the pertussis whooping cough one, and what was the other one? I can't remember what the other one was now. But for the first 6 months, we basically do like 2 vaccines every month. So instead of going in for like a 2-month appointment and then a 6-month appointment and then like a 9-month appointment, we just go in every month and we do fewer vaccines but more spread out. So by the time that, you know, she gets to a year or 2, she'll be like entirely vaccinated, caught up to her peers. So that's how we did it with Alex, and that's how we're doing it with her as well, and so it's working out great, and our nurse practitioner is totally on board with that. In terms of her development, like I said, her neck and upper back control is getting pretty strong now. I've been really bad about doing tummy time. I really should be doing that a lot more, but I mean, she does, you know, lay on us while we're reclined, and I guess that's kind of tummy time. And she spends a lot of time sitting up, like in her little chair, or, you know, we'll be like holding her. And so she is spending a lot of time like developing those muscles. She's not just on her back the whole time. So I feel like she is developing just fine there, but, I should be doing a little bit more tummy time. She is standing now. You can hold her like at her hips and she will stand there. Like, you don't even have to support her back anymore. She just will like stand there. Just, I was noticing today how much stronger she's getting. It seems like every day she gets a little bit stronger. For some reason, she loves standing up. So I have a hunch she's probably going to walk much sooner than her brother, since, I mean, her brother walked at 18 months. He was pretty late in that department. I think she's going to be a lot more likely to walk at a more average time. And she's going to be wanting to keep up with him. So anyway, she's definitely moving in that direction with standing up now. And she has become such a chatterbox. I think she might end up being just as much of a talker as her brother. She's an introverted child. She's very quiet and has the big eyes and takes everything in. But if you start interacting with her, if you look at her and talk with her, she just starts babbling away. It is so cute. I'll put in some videos here.
Really?
She's really turning into a little chatterbox now. In terms of her interests, she really likes things that spin. So we have this pinwheel, and Bill actually discovered that she really loved this thing. She was really upset one time. He started like blowing on the pinwheel, and she just like calmed right down, was like totally mesmerized by it. And so just things that spin like that, like the ceiling fan that we have in our room. She's really interested in that. Also, she has a little mobile on her swing that has, you know, these little like butterflies and birds that can like spin around and move around, and she loves that. It's kind of like her little interest right now. That and faces. She loves looking at faces. Like I said, you know, when you sit her up or stand her up, she loves just looking at you and talking with you. So that's how little Miss Sophie is doing at 3 months. There's not that much to talk about for me in terms of postpartum. I am now down 31 pounds, so definitely still moving in the right direction, about a pound a week, same rate that I was last month. Oh, I was also going to mention my little lady bits laxity problem that I mentioned before. I found a physical therapist, and so there's one that's about, you know, 20 minutes from our house, and so I started doing that. So that's been really, really good. I am also going back to the chiropractor now, since being pregnant really put a strain on my lower back, and now just like nursing. Even when I'm like editing videos, it's like the horrible like head forward posture, and I'm really trying to be aware of it. But you know, I definitely need to be going to the chiropractor regularly again to help with that. So I've started doing that again. I'll be going like once a week, and I'll also be getting a massage once a month. So that's what I've been doing in terms of recovery at this point. Everything else has been feeling pretty darn good. Except with the exception of when I was sick, I'm still trying to walk at least 5 days a week. So getting back into that now after being sick as well. One last thing I wanted to discuss was just this whole being a mom of two thing. It's like, I feel like I've got it under control at home, but like I mentioned before, getting ready to leave, it is such an ordeal. It takes us so long to get out the door. I'm still really bad at it. And when we're out, I still feel like I need backup a lot of the time. Like, I've done it. I've gone on a couple shopping trips by myself with both of them, but it is exhausting because inevitably one of them is fussing or crying, and just like, I know people around me are probably a lot more understanding than I think they are, but I'm just like so self-conscious about it. I'm like, you know, stressing out about it, feeling anxious, like trying to calm whichever child down, you know, and like doing what I have to do to like keep Alex occupied. Like, oh, we have to play I Spy, we have to bring crackers to keep him occupied, you know, just like constantly doing things to keep them happy during a shopping trip, for example, or wherever public place we're at. And some days are better than others. Like, some days have been like a total breeze, like we've done it just fine, and other days it's been a lot harder. So I'm definitely, you know, still trying to figure that out. I know it will get easier as they get a little bit older as well. That has been a bit of a challenge. But if I have Bill with me or one of our moms, then it always makes things a lot easier. That's it for the 3 month update. Thank you guys so much for watching, and don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already, and we'll see you next time. Bye.